Well, hello there people, here I am, because you guys responded to me in a very positive way when I asked you if I should do review videos. I'm going to give a try for the first time to this kind of content, but I'm sure that you didn't came here to hear about me, so how about we start with a little introduction to our topic. Megaman, Maverick, Hunter X and Megaman Powered Up were remakes of the first games of the Classic and X series of the Megaman franchise. Both came out for the PlayStation Portable system, and despite that nowadays they are very well loved by the community. Did you know that when they came out, they had their controversies that caused them to unfortunately fail in sales? That will be the topic that we would be discussing for today. Let's start with Megaman Maverick Hunter X. This remake was released on December 15th of 2005. Like it was mentioned before, this is a remake of the original Megaman X game for the Super Nintendo. This game featured a 2.5D visual style which is very similar to the one used for X8, but with brighter colors. The game also had voice acting, provided by some of the voice actors from X8.
File! I should've known you'd be involved in Sigma's rebellion.
It also features a remastered soundtrack, and allows the player to unlock Vile as a playable character. Despite being a remake, this game has a few differences with the original game, such as the armor parts being changed of position, that the Sigma stages have a new layout, and that the story is slightly different. But perhaps the biggest feature of this game is that it has fully animated anime cutscenes, including a short film known as The Day of Sigma, which you can find in the internet in case you wanna watch it. I had already played this remake and I have to say that it is just as good as the original Mega Man X. Some people may even say that it's better, so I really recommend it. It also includes a playable demo of Mega Man Powered Up, which is the next game we are gonna talk about.
Let's go! Ready? Let's do this!
Just like you heard, Mega Man Powered Up is another remake, this time of the first Mega Man game. This one was released on March 2nd, 2006, and unlike Maverick Hunter X, who tried to stay the most loyal as possible to the source game, Powered Up went for a different direction, and fully recreated many aspects of the original game, such as going for a much cuter and colorful art style and soundtrack. Changed the stages layout, and added two new robot masters, Oilman and Timon, as the original Mega Man game only had 6 robot masters. This game also featured voice acting, which by the way, the voices from that game are also the ones used on the GMOD videos I make. The greatest features from this game are many, such as unlocking the robot masters as playable characters, being these one of the few times this guy's playable, Protoman. Roland, her many costumes as unlockables too, a challenge mode and a stage builder where you could upload your own stages for other people to play them. And in case you are not really a fan of the new style of the stages, there is an old style mode where you get to play the stages from the original games. I have played this game too, and despite this game can result a bit hard, especially if you play as a robot master, it is definitively worth to give it a try. Both Maverick Hunter X and Powered Up were really well received by the critics, and because of all of the good things I have said about them, I'm sure you might think that these games sold well, right? Well, reality is often disappointing, as it turns out that both games were a failure in sales. But how is it possible that two remakes that were a direct upgrade to the games that they were based from failed in sales? Well, let's dive right in into the possible reasons for why these games failed. Let's start again with Maverick Hunter X. The strongest reason of why this game failed has a relation with the Mega Man X collection for the GameCube and PlayStation 2. This was a compilation of every X series game from X1 to X6, including Mega Man Battle and Chase as a bonus game. In this case, it was promised that these games would receive voice acting by Ocean Group, who were in charge of the voice acting in X8 and Command Mission, and it seems that in fact, voice clips were recorded. However, when the collection arrived, these new voice clips couldn't be heard anywhere. Some sources indicate that Keiji Inafune took these new voice clips that were meant to be used for this collection and saved them instead for the Maverick Hunter X remake series. If this is true, this means that the voice clips heard on Maverick Hunter X were meant to be heard on the X1 version of this collection. As a result, when fans got to know about Keiji Inafune's actions, they decided to boycott Maverick Hunter X, and unfortunately, said boycott actually worked, because the game sold very badly, so this time, it seems that the fault was by both Capcom and the fans themselves. Other problems are that this game was released on the early days of the PlayStation Portable, and because jailbreaking one of these consoles for piracy was not really that difficult, led it to Maverick Hunter X to be greatly affected by it being one of the most pirated games of a console. Many people also complained about the game not being available for the Nintendo DS, where many other Mega Man games were at, but I really doubt that a port of Maverick Hunter X for the DS could have really worked. Now let's move with Mega Man Powered Up. When it comes to Mega Man Powered Up, it had similar problems to Maverick Hunter X, such as being one of the most pirated PlayStation portable games. However, if we really want to find a specific reason, we have two alternatives. The first is that its cute looking art style could have resulted childish for some players, and as a result people refused to buy it. Another reason is related to the controversy with the new robot Master Oilman, who had his design changed. This was because in the Japanese version of the game, Oilman is seen with a black color palette and pink colored lips, which was labeled from some people as a racist stereotype. Later in the international releases, color palette was changed to blue with yellow lips. This controversy could have also affected the game, and I bet that if this happened on the present days, it would have been even worse. It is also worth mentioning that in the Archie comics of Mega Man, Doyleman's lips are always covered by his scarf. At the end of the day, the bad sales of these two remakes took down the idea of Capcom and Keiji Inafune to make more of these remakes, as it was planned to remake the entire Classic and X series games, meaning that there were plans for things like Mega Man Powered Up 2 and Maverick Hunter X 2, but unfortunately because the fans didn't really support these games, they were all cancelled. Although that doesn't mean that Capcom is innocent in this scenario, as they also were very responsible for its failure because of their weird decisions. Luckily, Maverick Hunter X became the 10th best-selling game on the PlayStation Network later on April 2014, and Powered Up would still have a small yet active community who made their own stages on the Stage Builder. Unfortunately, the servers of this game are about to close at the end of November, which at the moment that this video is being made is literally today, which is very sad, but luckily the community made many backups of the data on the servers. Nowadays these two games are very well loved by the Mega Man fandom, and even some people like me would like to see these games being released again for modern consoles, or maybe even more remakes of the other games. Although this doesn't seem very possible, because I don't think that Capcom would give it another try to these remakes, because of the bad sales they had, and because we are talking about Mega Man, we get a new game of the franchise only when the planets of the solar system get aligned with each other, which is why I don't really have high expectations for the 35th anniversary of the series. I bet that all we are getting is a dumb event for Mega Man X Dive and maybe a bunch of silly and cheap merchandise. But how about you? Did you like these games? Would you like them to make a comeback? Do you think that Capcom will do something relevant for this anniversary? I will read your comments down below. Well, that's all for today. See you guys next time, and have an amazing day.